throughout a season, of course, there's certain hunts that are extra special for whatever reason. And on this show, well, I'm bringing you all the best of season two. A place that people all around the country want to hunt. And there's a good reason for it. They have absolutely giant bucks. Now, I've wanted to hunt it for quite some time too, and in fact, it took me 4 years to draw this archery tape.
I decided now's the time to hit the antlers, snort, wheeze, grunt, do a little sequence, and that might just use that real buck running off as the perfect decoy to bring in the big boy. If this big wide buck had been watching the entire thing, but when I hit those antlers together, did that sequence, that brought him right in. And as he got closer, he slowed down and was eyeballing that decoy. My heart was racing. He's coming right in and has no idea we're there until he gets close, suddenly stopped and looked up right at me. Giant buck come in. We just got set up. I hit the grunt call just a couple of times and he came just bolting out from the side. He came right in, looked perfect coming into my decoy. And I don't know if he smelled something or what, but he looked right up at me, spooked a little bit. I did not have much of a clear shot, but I saw a little opening, thought I could make it through it, and I snapped a branch right in half. It looked like it was going perfect. Now the hardest part is, well, I was supposed to be done. This was actually the end of my hunt, but I decided I'm not going anywhere. The bucks, they were rutting and this spot was too good and I'd waited too long for the tag. So I decided I'm gonna hunt one more morning. My whole body is just shaking. We saw that buck. He came in and he was right on our decoy. I had some brush in my way, the same branches as yesterday, but this time I waited. Oh, that was so awesome. What an awesome buck. Look at the time length on this. I was so shook up when he came into my decoy. I don't know if I could have told you how big he is, but look at this. Just nice to see all your hard work pay off. We stuck it out, and I'm taking home a beautiful Iowa buck.
and wallet. Peak, run true.
Do you want to get into some real excitement this fall? Well, scrape hunting is one of the best ways to hunt trophy bucks. The Magnum Scrape Dripper by Wildlife Research Center drips daytime only, so it conditions your buck to come in during daytime hunting hours only. It's activated by the rise in temperature, so batteries aren't required. Temperatures generally rise during the daytime and drop at night. This conditions a buck to visit your scrapes during those hunting hours. Hang your Magnum Scrape Dripper above the scrape as high as you can reach while standing on the ground. Golden Scrape is a perfect blend of golden estrus and intruding buck scents with subtle tones of fresh scrape earth tones. Plus, it's got a little bit of territorial musk. So this powerful scrape smell, well, it really heats up the scrapes. Scrape hunting is a great way to hunt whitetail bucks, and it's a great time to watch them come in and go after your scrapes that you've made. So try Magnum Scrape Dripper this fall and really increase your odds of success. Now we're back with some of the best of Winchester Deadly Passion from season 2. So next up, well, I was heading to Newfoundland. Now this was gonna be my first ever moose hunt. I was going with Bob Efford with Efford's Hunting Adventures, and this was a fly-in location. We were gonna be in a spike camp with Glen, our guide, and I was pretty excited because Newfoundland, well, it is known for its huge moose population. It is really an incredible area, and this was gonna be an absolutely amazing hunt. We went out and our plan was to try to get up as high as possible. That way we could get a vantage point over this entire area and hopefully find what we were looking for. Well, after about a half a day of glassing, we had spotted a beautiful moose way out in the distance. We were watching him through the spotting scope and we made a plan and went for it.
Oh.
Huh?
Yeah. Another shell in there in case you...
I can see him again. Should I put one more in him? Glen?
Yeah.
You got him though. He's not going nowhere.
That was awesome.
Good job.
That was a beautiful moose.
Excellent job, Melissa.
I'm shaking pretty bad.
Yeah, you are.
You seem to be pretty cold.
Oh. Is your first moose, is it?
That's my first moose ever.
Yeah. Man, what a moose.
Look at all. What a beautiful moose.
Beautiful, isn't it?
Yes, no, he is. Not only is he a beautiful one, but he's my first one ever. Wow, look at the size of this thing.
Man, wow. Wood too.
Really nice. Just a beautiful moose. We're out here hunting with Efford's Hunting Adventures, and it has been just an incredible trip. Newfoundland is a beautiful area, tons of game all over, and when you can come out here and get a beautiful moose like this, well, it makes it quite a trip. This is my first moose ever, and I am just having an amazing time. But the cool thing about moose, well, they've got a ton of meat. And the bad thing about moose, you gotta pack all that meat out. So we got right to work before we lost any more light, and one pack after another, we got that entire moose out. Well, this is the last load. We got the rack up here, and cut off a little bit of the back straps just to have for supper tonight. We've put in a lot of miles today. It's been a really long day, but we got everything packed out. It was almost dark. In fact, we started packing a little bit in the dark, but now we get some excellent meat tonight, get some good rest, and see what we get to hunt tomorrow.
This segment was brought to you by U.S. Sportsman's Alliance. Our heritage, our fight. Protecting hunting from coast to coast.
Did you know that sportsmen and women contribute nearly $8 million to the economy every single day, adding more than $2.9 billion every year for conservation? Just another fun fact showing how sportsmen and women are helping make a difference.
Winchester Deadly Passion is presented by Cutty Back Digital, hard-hitting Easton Arrows, Hunter's Safety System, Winchester Repeating Arms, Swarovski Optic, Scent Killer Gold with Hunt Dry Technology. Apply it, dry it, and go hunt. Rage Broadheads, leading the evolution in lethal technology. U.S. Sportsman's Alliance, protecting hunting from coast to coast. And Golden Triangle Whitetail, your hunt of a lifetime awaits.
Alaska, well, they are known for some of the best black bear hunting in the entire country. And what I love about it, well, this was gonna be a self-guided hunt. Now, I was flying in with RDM pilot. Ryan McHugh was gonna fly me in, had a tent camp location, and from there, well, I was on my own. I had a kayak, a tent, my bow, and a predator call. My goal on this trip was to really kayak along, look for those black bears on the beach, and then make a stalk.
I'm so out of breath from blowing that predator call. Oh my gosh, he wasn't gonna turn. I can't even breathe right now. And I'm not sure if it's from shaking. I'm telling you, that comes down to you better make the shot or he's coming after you. I felt I had a little security with this log, but that's not enough. That was absolutely unbelievable. I think that's like the fifth or sixth bear I've called in with a predator call. I can see the blood trail from here. He is losing some serious blood. What a beautiful bear. This thing is a giant, and he came in on a dime. I'm out here, I was in a kayak, and I saw him from quite a ways out. I was able to sneak in super quiet. The problem is, when you hit the shore, you got that to contend with. Super noisy, and these bear, they have excellent hearing. Their sight might not be all that great, but they can hear anything. This is my third year up here, my third big boar with a predator call. These guys, they're pretty mean and hungry when they come out of the dens in the winter. Alaska's got some absolute giant black bear. This is what spring black bear hunting is all about.
Tip of the week is brought to you by Field & Stream. Trusted brands, timeless traditions.
As a hunter, it's extremely important to practice just like you hunt. Now, over the years, I've gotten used to not hunting with gloves, but I've found out the hard way that my hands just can't make it through the cold. Plus, your hands probably move the most on stand of anything, so they really should be camouflaged. So this year, I've made it my goal to practice with gloves and with my jacket on. That way, I can get out during the off season, get used to shooting with gloves, so when the weather turns cold, well, I can have them on and be comfortable. Now on these gloves, these are a great glove by Field & Stream. They have the no scent C3 technology and they've got just the right amount of warmth in them. They'll keep me warm during those late season hunts, but they will also be comfortable enough that I can feel my bow and still shoot. But just like everything, you need to practice with them. So that's why I'm out in my yard today practicing, wearing the jacket I'll be wearing so I'm completely comfortable on stand. Now you're gonna see that there's even touch text fingers. Now no, we don't all need to be on our phones out on stand, but if you do need to check something, it's really nice to be able to check them with your gloves on and quickly put it away. That way you're not wasting a ton of time pulling your glove off. All that movement on stand, completely unnecessary. Now with these, you're all set. The other thing I really like is if you look at the cuff, it's got just the right amount of cuff on it. It's not too long that goes all the way up your wrist, but it's very flexible and it works well. On this hand, I actually have my release right over the top of it, and that's how I've gotten used to shooting. You can put it under, put it over, whatever works best for you, but whatever you choose, we'll practice that way. So overall, this season, I'm gonna be out in those cold hunts, and this time I'll be wearing gloves because I'll have practiced all season with them on.
Winchester Deadly Passion is presented by Winchester, the American legend. Matthews, catch us if you can. Field & Stream, where traditions begin. ScoutLookWeather.com. Download the free DeerLog app for your smartphone. Moose Utility Division. Demand the brand. Bog Pod. Versatility defined. M&P by Smith & Wesson. And Peak Antifreeze. Right with your car and wallet. Peak. Run true. Closed captioning is brought to you by the 4-in-1 Woodsman from Zippo Outdoor.
Now there's a lot of different things that make up my favorite episodes of the year. Now of course, Iowa, well, I had waited so long, it was a great feeling of accomplishment. My Newfoundland moose, well, it was my first moose ever, and it really was an incredible trip. Now Alaska, calling in a huge black bear to 18 yards, well, that's adrenaline rush for anyone. But on this last trip, well, it was really a special hunt for me because I was able to take my dad and brother on a snow goose trip. Hunting snow geese, it's a lot of fun, it's quite challenging, and there's definitely a plentiful supply. Well, we just arrived in South Dakota, and it is freezing, windy, cold conditions, but it should be awesome for hunting snow geese. We got here, and there are literally thousands of geese all over the place. So what we're gonna do is head around, knock on some doors, see if we can get permission. We've got some decoys along, it's my dad, my brother, and I. We're gonna be out here having some fun. I have never seen so many geese just swarming the field. It really was incredible. Just the noise being, I don't know, 500, 600, 700 yards away, it's almost deafening. And it really is pretty cool. And the crazy part is, the snow geese, they're constantly moving. So a field that's good one day, well the next day, they may be completely gone. So we were gonna do it old fashioned. We were gonna go knock on doors, asking permission of where the snow geese were. And that's exactly what we did. And honestly, we had great luck. My dad, he has got the gift to gab. And he was going up to doors, getting things lined up while my brother and I were trying to go out and get after these snow geese. Now, yes, a lot of people can go out, you put 1,000 decoys out and you wait and you can bring them in, and that would be wonderful. But I didn't have 1,000 decoys, I didn't have a place to set up, and I wasn't confident enough in my skills as a hunter to bring that many geese in. So instead, well, we tried a different method. We were crawling out into these fields, trying to get in amongst them. We would get out there, try to set up if possible, but if not, we'd just get in and you could pass shoot them as they were coming through.
We had a wonderful time, and this isn't your conventional type hunt that I would usually do, but it was a wonderful trip with my family, and it was nice to pick my dad up to thank him for all the years that my mom and him brought us out hunting. It was just a great trip and a lot of fun, and I look forward to doing it every single year.